good afternoon. Thank you very much for attending our talk presentation on big data for middle school. So just a brief intro on what it's about. I've been teaching big data high school for the past 3 years. And in the past year or so, we see that there's a need to start expanding big data to middle school there. Now, just a very brief intro of the Concordia International School Shanghai. So we're actually located in China itself. And these are some of our statistics on our school. We run the American program. We have about 1160 students, about 148 teaching faculty, and one-to-one computer from grade 5 and grade 6 to 12 then. But basically, an international school that's catered for the expatriate community located in China. So this is just a little bit more about what the school is about. Right? And without further ado, I'm going to introduce Grace Wei, who helped me to develop the program for big data for middle school. Grace?
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Grace. I'm currently a senior at Concordia International School Shanghai. I took the Big Data Analytics course last year as a junior, and before taking the course, I had absolutely no idea what Big Data is. But after a semester, I feel like I found a new interest, or I can even call it as a new passion. I'm particularly fascinated by how powerful Big Data is, by how just mere numbers can have such an impactful influence on myself and the world. How I can change lives, how I can save lives, and how I can give us so much more time. And other than big data, my other interest is education. And luckily, Dr. Tong has given me this golden opportunity to combine my two interests in this project, which is developing a big data course for middle school students. And I'm so honored to be standing here today and sharing with you about some information about this course. And let's get started. So first, I'm going to answer this fundamental question of why are we promoting this course, and there are mainly five reasons. The first one is we want to stress about the importance of computer or computational literacy in our lives. Technology is important, as we have all recognized already. It is relevant to every field. And thus, we just want to let the middle school students to be able to have the opportunity to have a experience in getting in touch with these elements. And so no matter what discipline the students go into, some training in computer or computational literacy is going to be helpful. And here, computer literacy refers to the ability to be able to use computers. And computational literacy refers to the ability for students to be able to solve problems using computational technologies, and which requires students to know some level of programming, but it can range from just running a simple Excel formula to running an entire elaborate computer system. And in this course, the students will be studying how to use these three softwares: Tableau, Excel, and IBM Watson Analytics. These three softwares will let them be more familiar with how to use computers for a more legitimate reason other than just programming or having fun. Other than just having like gaming and then YouTube videos. And also will be helpful in your later lives too. The second reason is what I am most appreciative after taking the course myself is being exposed to this concept of big data. Big data is relevant to all fields, and it has becoming an important tool when it comes to this decision-making process. Insurance companies use big data to evaluate a person's credibility, or retailers can optimize their stock based on the predictions generated from social media data, or personal smartwatches or bracelets are collecting personal data that can be later used to It is transforming how we live, think, and work. So it is not only important for the current generation to know the importance of big data, but more importantly than for the younger generation to be exposed, because they will be the ones who are more influenced by this idea as this big data technology advances. And from my personal experience, I also feel like after learning about this subject, I am more knowledgeable as a person in the society because I know more about each field that is related to from hearing examples how this operates. It has made me realize how the world makes decisions, and I really wish that the middle school students are able to have this opportunity to feel what I have felt even earlier at this stage. Being exposed to this concept will let them learn more about themselves. They can explore their own interests because the design of the course will allow students to have this chance to combine their interests with the skills they learn in this class and to generate something that they really care about. And because they will be doing this self-directed project later as the final or major section of this course. Also, they can discover new passions just as I did, because this is going to be a new field that the middle school students are being exposed to. Maybe they will find interest in this field as well. So it will provide more choices of careers for them, as big data has a lot of other job titles as well. And also, it will let them know more about themselves as in their, what are their strengths, what are their weaknesses, and also what they enjoy, what they really enjoy doing, or what they don't enjoy as much. The fourth reason is to fulfill the demand of big data scientists. As we know that there's a lack of data scientists in the world, in the job market right now. But it is predicted that by 2018, there will be at least 1 million data scientists needed, which universities or high schools or professional schools are not training them fast enough. So maybe starting with the middle school students can help to reach this goal sooner and just benefit the world as a whole. The final reason is to meet the purpose of middle school. Middle school is not just about learning grammar, learning mathematics, learning history, learning about science. It is a person's transition from being a child to being a teenager. And it is often the stage where they are questioning or discovering or wondering about their passions and their personality. So, and other than knowing who they are, it is also a time when they start to learn important life skills, such as learning to research, learning to think critically, and also to being able to analyze things, which are all important qualities in this big data subject. Also, they will be able to learn how to be a better team player, and they can be more creative because big data leads them to think maybe sometimes outside of the box to find a correct correlation. And they will learn to be more detail-oriented as well as being able to look at the whole picture instead of just focusing on one point. Another important part about middle school is that it is a time when students are encouraged to be a part of the society. And this course can be their first step because it is when they will be in touch with the world, knowing what is happening outside of their own family and their own school community. And they'll just get a more general sense of what is it like out in the real world. And it's just gonna be a bridge for them to connect them with the outside world. Well, some people may say that middle school students are too young to understand this introduction, near the end of their introduction, the students will be presenting on what they have learned. They will be reflecting on what they've learned as maybe like a new subject, and also what are their future goals, what are they looking forward to in later classes. It can be an opportunity for students to tell the teachers what do they look forward to. Some resources for part one will be this book, Big Data, A Revolution of How We Live, Think, and How We Work, Live, Work, and Think Together by Victor Mayer Schoenberger and Kenneth Kuecker. Sorry, I don't know how to pronounce your names properly. But this is the textbook that the high school course has used last year, at least for my year. I really enjoyed reading the book because it has given so many great examples, and the language is very simple and very direct. So for us, each student was responsible for one chapter, and we became the teacher and taught and shared our information with the class. But it's kind of going to be different with the middle school students, as they don't quite have the ability, that strong ability to carry on the class. So the teacher will be the director. And then they will be, I don't think they will be reading the entire book, but they will be focusing on the first chapter, where it's the introduction and telling them general sense of what is big data, and also the seventh chapter, which is about the risks of big data. Other than the book, there are many YouTube videos online that introduce what is big data. They can be used as a hook to the course or like a more general, given in more another review for what is big data. So this is one example and another example. They have great animation, and then the language is simple, of course. Part two will be focusing on showing more examples of how big data is used in everyday life. This part will not be long. It will take approximately 5 sections. But the key is just to convey the message that big data is in everyday life and it is happening around us. And this can be achieved by showing examples that is relevant to students' lives, such as examples in social media, gaming, or sports, or maybe food as well. And some resources for this is TED Talks and YouTube videos, such as Amy Webb's How I Hacked Online Dating, and Ola Roslin's How Not to Be Ignorant About the World, which I portal, UN Data, data.gov, the World Bank, UNDP, and UNESCO. So for this session, the instructor will be teaching students how to find data from credible sources. And the last part will be the most important part of this course. It will take about 19 classes where students will find their own interests and what they really care about to combine the skills that they've learned to find out what they really want to know too. They will complete the entire process by themselves, maybe individually or with group members. And at the end of this course, they will be presenting on what they've learned. And some cautions with teaching. As I mentioned, big data has many risks. So other than like privacy issues, I think it is a time when the teacher can focus on telling them that big data is not omnipotent. It's also when we have to appreciate and cherish our human qualities, such as our emotions, our intuitions. And also the teacher will be stressing about the importance of proper interpretation, how proper interpretation should not be biased, it should be objective, and proper interpretation by the subject matter expert is essential here. The expected outcome of this course can be concluded in three words: exposure, application, and awareness. By the end of the course, the students are expected to be well-versed about big data. They will know, they can explain to others what is big data, how is it used in life, and also the benefits or the dangers of big data. And also, they will know what is going on there outside of their school, and just learning what is the trend in the world too. They will learn about the world and themselves as they work on the projects, their own directed projects, and they will also be more enthusiastic in learning because they know that the knowledge they're learning right now is relevant and it is right now happening in their lives. So hopefully they will be more eager about learning about knowledge. And
so that's the presentation by Grace, and the reason why I wanted to bring her in to help develop this course is that, as Grace explained earlier on, that she's a newcomer to big data, but no exposure at all prior to the course. And upon finishing this course, she can look at it from a student's perspective, from someone who has no exposure at all to that. And that's why I wanted to bring her in to help me to develop big data to middle school.
Any questions?
Is this program rolled out now, or is this something that's just to be rolled out?
Yes, we just started this in August. So yeah, it's about 3 months now into it. So Grace actually did this work started around this time last year. And later on in my presentation, I'll be talking about how this course is being run as well. Sorry?
How many people took the course?
Right now we have about 20 students in the Big Data for Middle School.
And
then
the course just for, I think, this week, right, in middle school right now. Yeah, so it's just been implemented.
So which year is that?
This course is actually open to grade 7 and 8.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. So I'm not sure what the equivalent is to the UK system.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well done.